Good morning again. Around 60,000 people were evacuated from their homes in Sydney's southwest last night as up to 150 millimetres of rain smashed parts of the city. Heavy downpours are continuing throughout the day, well into the afternoon. The Georges River has peaked, but water levels are still at near major heights around Liverpool. Major flooding is predicted on the Hawkesbury and Nepean rivers, with suburbs like Windsor and Richmond told to brace for flooding not seen in years.
So really, residents on or near any rivers, creeks and streams, particularly these rivers, if you were impacted last year or last week and you haven't been already, those rivers are still rising. So please stay up to date with the latest forecasts and warnings.
While the rain should ease by the evening, strong gusts of wind are predicted from tomorrow. Sadly, there are reports a body has been found in Western Sydney floodwaters. Police had been looking for a mother and her son after their car was found in the stormwater canal at Wentworthville. Officers were alerted after the sedan was found in the Cooper Creek stormwater canal late yesterday afternoon. Police found personal possessions inside, but they haven't been able to locate the car's owner or her 34-year-old son, who was believed to be with her. Thousands more Australian Defence Force personnel will arrive in flood-affected communities in northern New South Wales and southeast Queensland in coming days. Defence Minister Peter Dutton says that the number of defence troops assisting flood recovery efforts would rise to 5,000 by the end of the week. The ADF will help to clear roads and fix telecommunication networks, and will use helicopters to drop critical supplies to cut off communities. Prime Minister Scott Morrison has said a further round of financial assistance would be provided to affected areas of both Queensland and New South Wales.